Welcome to apnephysics.com. Today we are discussing about the electromagnetic wave. We know that electromagnetic field wave have two components. One is the electric field and second is the magnetic field component. If either one of these is given, so how to find out the second field component? For an example, if electric field component is given, so how to find out the magnetic field component? And if suppose magnetic field component is given, so how to find out the electric field component? These are the two basic components of the electromagnetic wave. So in this lecture, I have to show using the Maxwell equation. One is the Faraday law and second is the Ampere's law. So using these two equations, I have to find out either of these two one. So first of all, I am using the Maxwell equation, which is defined by del cross E is equal to minus del B upon del T. This is curl of the electric field and this is time varying magnetic field. So this is the differential form of the Faraday law. Now if suppose E is given E is equal to E naught exponential power iota kx minus omega t and unit vector j. Here I have written this E, that is equal to E naught exponential power iota kx minus omega t and with this unit vector j. That define this E along the direction y. So I can write this E like this, EY, and because this E electric field component is a function of x and t. So this electric field component is showing that EM wave is propagating along the x direction. So one can find out the electric field component at any time t. So we know that if suppose this is the y axis, this one is the x axis. Here I have considered that electric field component is along the y axis. So this is the electric field component wave and these are the vibrations basically because of the electric field into the medium, and medium is free space. So these are the vibrations of the medium and this is the maximum amplitude, this one, this height of the vibrations on both the side, this is E naught. E naught is the amplitude of the electric field wave and these are basically vibrations into the medium, and by this way the electric field component propagate along the x axis and vibrations are along the y axis. And it is clear that we know in electromagnetic wave there are two field component, one is of the electric field and second will be मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, एंड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड ऑब्वियसली इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड अलोंग द वाई डायरेक्शन, वेव इज प्रोपेगेटिंग अलोंग द एक्स एक्सिस, इट मीन्स मैग्नेटिक फील्ड विल बी अलोंग द जेड डायरेक्शन. सो हियर मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इज अलोंग द जेड डायरेक्शन, इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड अलोंग द वाई डायरेक्शन, एंड बोथ कंपोनेंट्स इन द फंक्शन ऑफ एक्स एंड टी. सो इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज फंक्शन ऑफ एक्स एंड टी, मैग्नेटिक फील्ड दैट इज ऑल्सो फंक्शन ऑफ एक्स एंड टी. हियर ई वाई इज गिवन, दैट मीन्स इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड कंपोनेंट, एंड दैट कंपोनेंट इज वाइब्रेटिंग अलोंग द वाई एक्सिस. सो नाउ सपोज दिस वन इज द जेड एक्सिस, सो मैग्नेटिक फील्ड कंपोनेंट इज वाइब्रेटिंग अलोंग द जेड एक्सिस लाइक दिस वन. सो दीज आर द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड कंपोनेंट. सो मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इज वाइब्रेटिंग अलोंग द जेड एक्सिस. सो दिस इज द रिजल्ट ऑफ दीज टू फील्ड कंपोनेंट विच आर वाइब्रेटिंग परपेंडिकुलरली टू ईच अदर. दिस इज द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड कंपोनेंट एंड दिस वन इज द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड कंपोनेंट, एंड वेव इज प्रोपेगेटिंग अलोंग द एक्स एक्सिस. नाउ व्हाट इज गिवन? गिवन इज द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड कंपोनेंट दैट इज अलोंग द वाई डायरेक्शन. सो देयर आर टू वे ऑफ राइटिंग दिस इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड कंपोनेंट. Either you can write with this unit vector j, or you can write this by this way ey xt. Here I did not mention ey, but in the right hand side I have written j, unit vector j. So it means clear that I am considering y component. So these are two way of writing the component, first this one and second this one. So in the right hand side I don't need to write again this j, because I have mentioned here ey. So this is e naught, that is the amplitude, maximum amplitude of the vibration, and this solution I exponential part kx minus omega t, where x define the direction of propagation, omega is the angular frequency, k is the wave vector, t is time. So now with the help of this given electric field component, I have to find out this B. So how to find out this B, that is the point, and for that I am using this curl equation, and that is the Faraday law. So del cross E, so left hand side, that is del cross E, can be written as in the determinant form. So del cross E, this del cross E is equal to I J K and partial differentiation form del upon del X, del upon del Y, del upon del Z, and the electric field component E X, E Y and E Z. Now this point is very clear that y component of the electric field is given, other components are zero. So I will write here Ex is equal to zero, Ez is also zero, Ey, that is function of x and t, this is given. So now expansion of this determinant with respect to the unit vector ij and k. So I, when I consider this I, that I am leaving the component, this one horizontal and this column, I am considering this one. So del upon del Y, this Ez, and here Ez is equal to 0. So this term is equal to 0, and now when I consider this term, here Ey, differentiation of like this, I am writing this first this one this is 0, and now this one del Ey upon del Z, where Ey is function of x and t. So now the differentiation of this term will be equal to 0. The differentiation of this term will be equal to 0 because Ey is function of x and t, and you are differentiating with respect to Z. So this result will be equal to 0. Now for minus J. In case of J, I am leaving this column and this row. So I have this del upon del X and Ez, that is 0 minus del upon del Z and this 0. So this is 0 and again K. So in case of K, I am leaving this column and this row. So I have this del upon del X and this Ey. So del Ey upon del X, where Ey is function of X and T, minus this del upon del Y and 0. So this term is 0. So I have result of this. This is 0. This J component is also 0. And here for this K, this can be written as unit vector K del Ey upon del X, where this is function of X and T. So you can write this one. So here what I am doing, basically I just use the left hand side of this curl equation, that is Maxwell third equation, Faraday-Law, and into that I just put the value and find this result, that is del cross E, and del cross E is equal to with the component of K, I and J component are 0. So I can write this del cross E is equal to this unit vector K and del Ey upon del X, where I know that this Ey is a function of X and T, and the right hand side is this dB upon dt, because vector B can be written as bxi plus byj plus bz K. So dB upon dt in terms of these I and j k component can be written as del B upon del t is equal to del bx upon del t, del by upon del t, del bz upon del t k, right? So this dB upon dt can be written as in this way also. So now this is the left hand side and this is the right hand side. So I can write it with the negative sign as mentioned here. So that is, instead of this plus sign, I am using directly the negative sign, minus and this minus. Minus with this I cap, J cap and K cap. And this is equal to the left hand side, and that is unit vector K del Ey upon del X, and other component are 0. Component of I is 0, minus J is also 0, and for the K is this one. Now this equal to sign indicate that the component of the I, J and K will be equal to the component of this one and this. So I am comparing both the side according to the component. So when I compare the I component, so this del B X upon del T is equal to 0. When I compare the J component both the side, this del B Y upon del T minus del B Y upon del T is equal to minus this 0. So this is also 0. Now you see carefully what I did first. I just simplify the left hand side, that is del cross E, and find out the result for that. That is with this K component, and then after I use right hand side, expand that in terms of I, J and K, and now put together, and now I am comparing the components according to I, J, K. Here the component of I, J with this time varying magnetic field is equal to 0, and for the K component, this is del Ey, which is function of x and t, is equal to minus del Bz upon del t, and obviously Bz will be function of x and t, because wave is propagating along the x direction. So now I have an equation del Ey upon del x is equal to minus del Bz upon del t. There is no need to write these components because we have just compared the components only. So this del Ey upon del x is equal to minus del Bz upon del t. So now I have this result. So in the left hand side, in this side, what I have to do to find the value of Bz, first of all I have to simplify the left hand side, this side, and for this I have to differentiate this Ey with respect to x. So for that, now I am differentiating this electric field component. This is Ey. So del Ey upon del x is equal to, so this E naught is constant, and here when I will differentiate this term del Ey upon del with respect to x, so E naught is constant and this term will be differentiated, so I will write iota k. So iota k E naught, and rest of the term as it is, that is exponential term, iota kx minus omega t. So this is the differentiation of Ey with respect to x, and that is iota k E naught, exponential term, iota kx minus omega t. And now the right hand side is equal to minus dBz upon dt, and the left hand side is del Ey upon del x. So I have differentiated, that's result is this one. So I can put this here, this value, that is minus dBz. So this minus dBz upon dt, this is a partial differentiation, I am saying dt in general way. So minus dBz upon dt is equal to iota k E naught exponential part iota kx minus omega t. I have to find out the value of Bz. So for that I have to integrate both sides with respect to t. So now integrating both sides, I have to integrate both sides with respect to t. So when I integrate it with respect to t, what will be the result? So when I will integrate it with respect to t, it cancels, this differentiation of Bz will cancel out with this integration. So the writing it properly, my dBz upon dt, and this dt is equal to integration of it, that is iota k E naught exponential part iota k x minus omega t and dt. The differentiation of bz cancel out with this integration, so in the left hand side I have only minus bz. So bz is equal to this integration of iota k e naught exponential part and this. So when I will integrate this factor where I k e naught is constant, so integration is with respect to t, so this term iota minus omega, so this will come iota k e naught upon minus iota and this omega, and rest of the term it is iota kx minus omega t. So now this I cancel out and this negative sign with this negative sign. So I have the result bz is equal to this bz, that is function of x and t, is equal to e naught, and I can write this k like this omega upon k, so e naught omega upon k and exponential term, that is iota kx minus omega t, right? So now this e naught exponential term iota kx minus omega t is what? This is the electric field component, this is the Ey. So one can write in place of this E naught exponential term this Ey, that is the electric field component. And omega upon k, you know omega is equal to 2 pi nu, angular frequency, and this frequency of the wave where nu is equal to c upon lambda. So one can write 2 pi c upon lambda, because nu is equal to c upon lambda, and k is the v vector, that is 2 pi upon lambda. So omega upon k is equal to this one upon 2 pi by lambda. So when you will simplify it, you will get this c, because 2 pi by lambda cancel out by this 2 pi by lambda. So I cancel out, so I am getting this c. So here omega upon k is equal to c, and this factor is electric field component. So instead of this, I can write this bz is equal to ey upon c. So here bz, that is the magnetic field component along the z direction, function of x and t. This is the electric field component, and that is along the y direction, x and t, and upon this omega upon k is equal to c, that is the speed of light. So here one can write again after rearranging this, so c is equal to ey upon bz, and both are function of x and t. Right now, what is the important point? Point is that these are the component of the electric wave, component of the magnetic field wave. So Ey means all these information, and similarly Bz will be equal to, that is the magnetic field component along the z direction. This was the z direction, and this Bzxt is equal to B naught, that is the maximum amplitude along the z direction, exponential part iota kx minus omega t. So Ey and Bz are the electric field component and magnetic field component. So see, speed of light is basically equal to the ratio of electric field component and magnetic field component. When I put these value of Ey and Bz here, so Ey is equal to E naught, that is the amplitude of this electric field wave, and this exponential term, similarly this for magnetic field component, this is B naught, amplitude of the magnetic field wave. So after putting the value, I am getting this result. So C is equal to E naught upon B naught, where E naught is the amplitude of the electric field wave and B naught is the amplitude of the magnetic field wave. This is again the speed of light is the ratio of electric field component, amplitude of the electric field component to the magnetic field component. So C is equal to, in terms of the field component, in terms of the amplitude of these two different waves, electric and for the magnetic field wave. So this is the ratio of amplitude of electric field wave and the magnetic field wave. So by this you can find out, using these equations, that is the Faraday law. So if E is given, you can find out the Bz, and from this result we are looking that both are perpendicular to each other. Why? Because electric field component is along the y direction, wave is propagating along the x axis, and magnetic field component is along the z direction. So y and z both are perpendicular to each other, and they propagate like this one along the x axis. So if vector field component is given, E is given here, so you can find out the magnetic field component using the Faraday law. This is the Faraday law. Del cross E is equal to minus del B upon del T. So in the next lecture we will see that if magnetic field component is given, so how to find out the electric field component by using the Ampere's law. Thank you for watching this tutorial of apnephysics.com. Please subscribe the channel apnephysics.com and the Facebook page of apnephysics.com. Thank you.